The basic scan is one of the most widely used biosurveys in the ZYTO Select and Elite software. In this video, we're going to run through this popular scan to give you a better idea of its capabilities and how you can use it in your practice. So, let's get started by bringing up our client screen. I'm going to search for my test client and select, and then select New Session. Now, you can see all the available biosurveys, and we'll go ahead and look under this ZYTO Biosurveys All New tab. Within this tab, you'll notice that there are slight variations to the basic scan you can run depending on what you're trying to accomplish. But the most used ones are these top two. The basic scan focuses on the categories that you've pre-selected and your inventory. And then, the next one down is if you don't have those set up, you can easily just go in and choose the product companies that you want to focus on. And then, it also goes through what we call product rank and dosage, so you can get the biological preference when it comes to a dose. I'll just mention here that we also have the basic scan for balancers only, and then one for stressors only. The balancers only scan will only scan the product and service virtual items. So we're just looking for the top products and services rather than considering out-of-range stressors and how to bring those into range. And then the stressor scan is just the opposite. That's if we don't really care about the products right now, but we're more interested in discovering what may be out of balance for them in terms of stressors. This can be helpful if the practitioner has their own in-office solutions to help balance the stressor virtual items that show up. Now, some practitioners may be just using one product company, and that's just fine. And other practitioners may have several different product companies. One might be more nutraceutical or homeopathic. Another might be flower essences and so on. So you may want to choose a little bit from different products to run, and you can choose those manually with that basic scan. With that being said, let's go ahead and run this basic scan with product, rank, and dosage. This is going to be very similar to the balance biosurvey. But again, the nice thing about this is that instead of our basic balance software that focuses on one nutritional product line, the Select and Elite now opens it up where you can use multiple product lines. That's one of the biggest benefits of moving up to the Select or Elite software. So, let's start this. And you can see that we're scanning right now. At this point, you'd have the client put their hand on the hand cradle to read their galvanic skin response. And as long as they have a connection with each point on the cradle, the scan will run. You can see that this is scanning the vertebrae, teeth, meridians, organs, glands, and systems virtual items, and then it's going to come to a breakpoint. This breakpoint will quickly have you look at the information. Here, you can look for patterns in the data, and when you hover over an item, you can see all of the correlations. So you have the emotions that correlate to that tooth, the different organs, glands, and systems. You have the meridians that correlate to it. You can also come up here to the top and see the items that are out of range for any of these categories. When you select a category, it will highlight everything in that category down below. So this really gives you the ability to have a more holistic view of the person and the relationships between their functions and the organs and glands and systems. Another great thing about this software is that as you view these reports more and more and run the scans more and more, you become more adept at finding those patterns and trends. So you might find something that sticks out here. Another thing that's good about these breakpoints is that there may be an item on here that you don't want to explain to a client or that you don't think is relevant to the client. So you can uncheck it and it will not move forward with that item. But otherwise, you can just look it over and move forward with the items that are already pre-selected. So let's go ahead and click Next. And now I can go in and choose the nutritional product companies I use in my clinic. So these are the ones that I've pre-selected under my categories. If you've set up your custom category list, you can add any of those you want to scan as well. We go over how to create a custom category in the Managing Inventory video, so make sure to go back and watch that if you haven't already. But if you don't want to add any of your custom categories, just come down and choose the product lines you want to use. For this example, we'll just use the generic ABC products, but you can add as many as you would like to offer a more robust selection. Now we'll go ahead and click Next, and it will automatically go through that entire product line. So it's not going to go through just bits and pieces unless you've set it up that way. It will scan every product in that product line. Now another nice feature with this biosurvey is that it can scan generic products. So you have your branded product lines like this ABC products we selected, but you also have the option to scan generic vitamins, minerals, amino acids, and so on. So if you don't want to associate with a specific product company, you can just run the generic products. And then you could just use any brand of vitamin D or lavender oil, for example, if those are recommended. Or say you make your own herbs or essential oils. It makes using the generic products a dynamic and useful option for anything you make or have on hand that may not be included in the available product lines. This screen is also helpful if you forgot to set something up before the scan. It gives you a last chance, if you will, to add things before running the scan. So let's go ahead and click Next and run this now. Something that people also love about this basic scan compared to the balance scan is that the balance will automatically just take the top 8 to 10 products and put them on the report. But with the biosurveys in the Select and Elite, you get to see those top products before their scan. So, as you can see on this top screen, it shows all the top products, but you can actually choose which ones you want to include before the balancer rescan. So, maybe you don't have this one in stock, or you don't want to order it. You can just uncheck it. You basically have the final say of what product moves forward and ends up on the report. All right, let's go ahead and click Next now and move forward with these products. And now I come in here and set the dosing parameters and run that. This will allow us to get a custom dosage based on the person's responses. Keep in mind here that you would first need to put in a dosage range here on the left for each product you want to get the preferred dosage for. So if you did between 1 to 2 capsules here, it would scan and tell whether 1 or 2 capsules is the most coherent dosage for that virtual line. Okay, after doing this, now we come to the report. You can see that this report gives a quick overview of biomarkers that were scanned. The red dots are out of range, and you can see that number here. And these are the ones that the products are going to help us bring back into range. So we have our top items that bring everything back inside the circle, back into the green. And here's our top product based on the person's galvanic skin response in relation to that virtual item. A few things to pay attention to here. If that top product is bringing a lot of the out-of-range biomarkers back into range, obviously that's one you want to pay more attention to. And then it's also good to look at each product and ask what it does for that person. Basically asking, why did this person have a preference for this based on what we know about them? That might trigger an answer where you go, oh my goodness, I didn't even think about that with this person, and that makes perfect sense as to why they need that product. Another thing about these descriptions is that they're detailed. They come directly from the product company. And so one thing that's good to do here is look for similarities throughout the products in terms of their ingredients, what they're used for, and so on. So asking, what do the products have in common? That's another way to get a more holistic view of the person and better understand what their body is trying to say. After the product descriptions, we have the top services. So, these are the body's preferred responses to all the service virtual items that were scanned. And this gives you the opportunity to offer your other services to the client as well. So maybe foot zoning came up as the highest priority, and you offer that in your office, so you can get them into that service. Or if you refer a service out to other practitioners, you can have a wellness network where those people in your network are sending referrals to you as well when their client needs a foot zoning expert, for example. Another thing to look at with services is, again, how they're similar to help you get to the root of an issue. So what do these services have in common that may shed more light on what the person is dealing with? And then taking it a step further, how do these services relate to the products? What do they have in common? So that's another great exercise to go through with these reports. Okay, organ biomarkers is the next section of the report. And if you're familiar with the Balance software, you can see that this goes into a lot more in-depth information than that biosurvey. We have the responses for eyes, bones, joint tissues, veins, for example, in addition to the more basic biomarker virtual items like stomach, kidney, and so on. So a lot more detailed information. Then you have the vertebrae. This is just a simple bar chart from highest priority on down. Then the teeth. This is a great one to look at because you can come over here and quickly say, okay, this tooth is showing up as some type of a stress response. And then I can click on this vectoring tool and come over here and click on that tooth. And now I can see those correlations. You can see that this tooth is energetically connected to those highlighted organs, vertebrae, and TCM meridians. It's really fun seeing the practitioners' faces when they see how this can help them make those connections. This is also a beautiful thing when you're sitting down with a client and they can make those connections as well. It gives them a better understanding that you're not trying to focus in on one specific item, but you're trying to see holistically. And so many times with this, the client will look at what shows up and say, you know, I never told you about that, and it's showing up here. And they're like, yeah, this is an issue for me. So it's amazing that the scan picked it up. So when you show them this information, their buy-in is very high and their compliance with the model that you have set up increases. You're able to continually bring up information so you can make proper choices and give them a better awareness of what may be going on for them. Okay, moving on. We have TCM meridians, which is also great. Meridians have a huge impact on our wellness, so you can see what needs to be prioritized there. And then the EAV points, which are related to the meridians. Then, scrolling down further, we have the emotional biomarkers. You can come over here if you want to focus in on what emotions might play into the person's overall situation. And what's helpful here is that emotions also correlate with organs. Anger is energetically connected to the liver, for example. So you can see how these connections may be playing out here. And an emotion will often show up here, and the person will initially be like, no, I don't feel that way. But then you start talking to them more about it, and they become more aware of it and end up saying, well, yeah, I guess I can see why that showed up. Another thing I'll mention with the emotions is that a lot of practitioners use the Evox software along with their Select or Elite. The Evox is really a fantastic complementary tool that helps to address the emotions that are showing up on a scan. So you might see a certain emotion show up and then you can say, well, let's talk about that. And then you run an Evox session that gives them an effective way to reframe their perceptions on that topic. Moving on with the report, you can see we have neurotransmitters, which are often overlooked when it comes to health and wellness. And then below that, we have the biomarker progress chart. This allows you to see the specific biomarkers that each product is bringing into range. So on the first column, you can see all the biomarker virtual items that were scanned. And then the next column is showing how the first product impacted the biomarkers, and then the second product, third product, and so on. So if there's still a number in this column, it means that the biomarker is still out of range. You would have to scroll down further to see which biomarkers this first product brought into range. Anything that's blank in that first column is what was brought into range by that first product. And then you can see in the other columns that once that number disappears, that the product that brought that biomarker has been brought into range. This progress chart is super helpful. because you can see more detail about what's being brought into range, but it also allows you to see the most stubborn biomarkers. Stubborn biomarkers are those that require the most products to bring back into range. So a few of the biomarkers may not have come into range until the fifth or sixth product was introduced. Then you can start asking specific questions about why those specific biomarkers took more effort to bring back into range. So, are they related? Is that something we need to look at more closely? Questions like that. Along with this primary report, there are several other reports you can look at with this scan as well that can give you a lot more helpful information. And you can just come up to the top left of the screen and pull down this drop-down menu to see all of those. Now, we have a version of this main report that has the full graphic charts in it. We also have a more basic version of the report called the standard report. Then, we have vector reports for all the organs, systems, TCM meridians, and emotions. So I mentioned how you can look at the vectors tab to look at connections, but these reports actually do the vectoring work for you. So you can come down here to the emotions vector report, scroll down, and see the top five out-of-range virtual items. And then further down, you can see the parts of the body that the item is energetically connected to. That's some very useful data that can help you look at the client in a more holistic way and see what may be having an impact on certain issues they're having, how one thing may be affecting these other vectored areas. Then, the other reports. You can see we can look at all product responses, just the general balancers, all the balancers, all the balancers by category, and then a probiotic report if you scanned probiotics, a services report with all the service responses, and finally, a report that shows the responses of all stressors that were scanned. So really, you have a wealth of information here with almost 20 reports, and they help you break down that information in a variety of ways. Okay, that's just a general overview of the basic scan. Now that you're familiar with this biosurvey, I would suggest moving on to the next video, which covers the advanced scan. Also, if you want to learn more about the other features on the Select and Elite software, make sure to visit our website at ZYTO.com.